A very warm welcome to all the new Hivarians. I hope you are doing good and having a great time. I'm Nilipta Panda, Senior Manager HR. I will be doing your induction today. We will start with a brief introduction of the company and its portfolio, and then we'll proceed towards the introduction of the departments. At the end, I'll be taking you through the HRMS platform and we will discuss few important policies there. Let's start with a short video clip. So now let's talk about our vision and mission of the company. Our vision is to transform businesses through path-breaking solutions. We believe in core values like meritocracy, result-orientedness, and passion. We have a mission called BHAG. The name BHAG is also called as BHAG, to be the number one preferred IT solution company in whichever market and segment we operate in, with a turnover of around 2500 crore by 2028. That's our target. We also want to be listed in NSE, BSE by 2028. Just a fact, we have already crossed 100 crore club. Recently we have actually celebrated the anniversary of our company and the crossing over of 100 crore club. Now moving on to the a brief about Hybar. IT expertise backed by industry domain knowledge differentiates Hybar as preferred partner for IT initiatives in infrastructure industry. Hybar has developed SAP certified templates based on industry best practices, enabling our customers to achieve business efficiencies. We are now offering IT services across multiple sectors, manufacturing, BPO, agrochemicals, telecom, consumer products, pre-engineered buildings, etc. Hybar has selected the infrastructure industry as a niche industry to serve because the IT adoption in this industry was very minimal and industry had multiple business challenges. And we are proud to tell you that Hybar has established itself in a strong position in this industry by solving all these business challenges for over around 150 plus customers in a very short span of time. We have done 75 plus end-to-end infrastructure ERP implementations, 40 plus SAP end-to-end real estate industry implementation. That's why we are known as India's first digital platform management project management platform using 5D, BIM and ERP. We are also known for being Asia's first company offering end-to-end IT solutions, focusing infrastructure and real estate industry. We have a strong group lineage. As I mentioned, as you have seen in the video, we hail from HCC Group. We were part of HCC Group, but after a few years, we have separated and established our own identity. We separated from HCC Group, wherein Mangesar has 51% of stake now. We are the only IT company who provide a total focus on infrastructure and real estate. We have around 11 case studies published as business transformation studies by SAP. SAP Labs chose Hybar for infrastructure and real estate product improvement. That's a very big point for us. We have largest pool of consultants dedicated for this industry. Recently, we have achieved around 400 plus employees count. We started off with a very few employees, and we have now reached over a very short span. We have reached around 400 plus, and now we are planning to boom it to around 1,000. We are also certified CMMI level 5. Now let's move to the achievements. So we have secured first comprehensive SAP ERP implementation in India. We are winner of four times winner of SAP ACE awards. And there are around 11 case studies, as I mentioned. That's the maximum number of infrastructure and real estate industry SAP global case studies for your information. And by far, we are the number one SAP implementation partner. And we are winner of best partner with industry focused award also in 2013. And there are many more. Now moving to geographical presence. We are there in multiple countries apart from India. We are there in Dubai, Oman, and other Middle East countries. We have a vast India presence. We are catering to the remote location of India. So name any remote location, Hybar has already its presence in there. So now let's move to offering portfolio. Hybar offers a wide range of portfolio. We are into IT consulting. We are into business process consulting. We are into LOB application portfolio, training and change management, IT infrastructure and support, and other such offerings. We offer services starting from IT architecture and procurement assistance, installation and ongoing support in case of IT infrastructure and support. We also give with ICE, we have a more methodology called ICE, involve communication and educate. With that approach, Hybar enables change management during the SAP implementation for various organization. We also, through our business process consulting services, we enable infrastructure and real estate companies to design, to redesign the business processes to achieve improvement in their critical contemporary modern measures of performance. Hybar, with its expertise in project management for construction, infrastructure, and real estate projects, we manage PMO from defining project charter to establishing PMO office to project change management. Through IT consulting services, we have enabled organization for IT strategy alignment with the organization business strategy. So these are a few of the offerings portfolio we actually have. We also we are also looking at SAP modules like PS, HCM, Fiori, Refex, and PM, MM, etc. Hybar has developed industry best practices in infrastructure, real estate, and ready-mix concrete industry. This has been certified by SAP. Starting, we offer services, multiple services in various SAP modules. So these are our esteemed clients. We have big names like Ambuja Realty, Prestige, Tata Realty, Lodha, etc. And in infrastructure industry, we have multiple names like BEC and then Samsung, Bescon, Stainer, etc. We also have government clients. Apart from our private business, we also cater to government businesses. And we have majority of our revenue from government businesses. So we have Nagpur, we have Pune Metro. Our biggest client is MSRDC. We also have CPWD, AURIC, Bhubaneswar, Smart City, etc. We also cater to other industry. You can see Titan, etc., DMart. These are a few of the other projects. Now coming to our landmark projects, starting with Lavasa City, India's first privately built smart city in 2008, Hybar has retained its position for preferred IT implementation partner for any kind of smart cities project. So we have Aurangabad Smart City, Bhubaneswar Smart City. After that, we have Nagpur Metro, Ministry of Road Transport and Transport and Highway. We are also also having Samruddhi Mahamarg as our one of the landmark project, SECI as another landmark project. Now coming to our organogram. So I'll take you briefly through the organo chat here. We have our CEO as Mangesh Wadje, and to him actually we have multiple heads reporting to. So I'll start with the first COO. Our COO is Upagupta Patnaik. He also handles the business development for private part. So basically, he is also head of business development private. We have Joydeep Banerjee as head of business development government. We have head HR and admin, and we have head marketing as Kunal Mamuchara. We also have AGM accounts and finance as Nadeem Sheikh. To COO, there are three more head of the department who reports to the COO. That is, process delivery and transformation office is headed by Anil Sir, Anil Kumar Jeyur. Delivery is totally under Kaustav Das. Technology and innovation is under Ashok One. So now I'll move to department overview. Let's start with business development. So business development has two parts. That is, one is for private businesses, one is for government businesses. We call private as prime and we call government as strategic. So private business, the CEO, the head of the private business and government business report to CEO, and then there are regional BD managers, solution architects under them. So business development departments, basically the key activities are sales department. It is lead generation, meeting with prospective customers and coordinating with pre-sales team, customer acquisition, etc. And for pre-sales, it is they have SAP solution demo, they are POC for specific customers requirement, they do solution presentation and preparation of proposals and SOW. Now the Hybar sales cycle lead to order process is as follows. First, it starts with lead creation and then converting to prospect and then converting to opportunity, then follow-ups and then proposal sending and negotiation, and then converting to order and collecting the advance payment and handover to delivery department. I'll come to the delivery department. Your delivery department, we have a separate structure because it is currently combined under head of the delivery department. Although we have a separation as prime and strategic, we don't show it here because we have now recently clubbed it under a particular department called delivery. Head of the delivery reports to COO and COO in turn report to CEO. Under head delivery, we have a COE and WFM department. We have program managers, multiple program managers, and then functional SMEs and tech leads. Under program managers, we have project managers and senior consultants and consultants reporting to those project managers. Now, delivery team is responsible for end-to-end execution and going live and support for IT projects. So the whole life cycle of the project is handled by the delivery team. And their key activities, there is a external delivery team which are involved as a part of it's an extension of delivery team. They provide support to sales and pre-sales. They support in building talent pool and development of new competencies. Now coming to process delivery and transformation office, this is recently being established when we are booming. Our business is booming. We had a requirement of process delivery and transformation office. Now the head of the PDTO is Anil Kumar Jayod. He is reporting to COO and COO in turn report to CEO. He will be recruiting few contract managers and consulting managers. PDTO office has recently been built. Earlier Anil sir was heading strategic businesses in delivery department. Now he has moved to process delivery and transformation. Apart from that, he's also handling the recruitment department. That is, he is also a head of recruitment. Now let me come to the key activities in PDTO. So basically, PDTO department looks after process excellence and contracts management. In contract management, basically they review, they draft, they evaluate the contracts, negotiation, etc. So they are the POC for clients for any contractual matters. Process excellence, they also look into governance of the processes, business transformation roadmap, how is it catering to the customer, whether they have a focus on value creation. So basically they monitor all the performance matrices. Now, coming next is our technology and innovation. So we have a single lead for technology and innovation. Under him, Ashok Wani is the head of technology and innovation. Under him, there are multiple things. One is innovation sub department, and there is a technology department. So under technology, there is software management part function. There is a IT infrastructure function. So he is head of the technology and innovation. He reports to CEO and CEO reports to CEO. So now under technology and innovation, there are tech leads, managers, project managers, the IT officers, software engineers, etc. Technology and innovation has a key role. There are few, we also have LOB solution products. So they look after the development and customers acquisition. They do order booking for new products and they deliver key projects. So they are also part of, they also look into the internal automation part. So all the internal processes, automation, they are managing it. Then they are also looking into organization strategic initiatives. So they assist in and sponsor strategic initiatives also. Now, few of their solutions. Let's speak about few of these services, LOB services and products. So they have done EasyBid, that is estimation and tendering for construction industry. So it tracks the equipment depreciation, work distribution, the standardization of estimation process, etc. They have also implemented IoT, construction equipment efficiency, for construction equipment efficiency. It's equipment location tracking tool. It also gives automatic reporting of equipment working, idle hours, etc. Now, let's move to the next part, that is contract and claims document management. That's another application which they have provided. So in that, there is a standardization of letter formats. There are alert mechanism in the workflows. This application has reduced the cycle times for claims and dispute settlements. They also have developed subcontractor billing product on SAP platform. So that's a very flexible tool which has been built for subcontractor billing processes. Now, coming to accounts and finance department, we have accounts finance head, that is AGM accounts and finance, headed by Nadeem Sheikh. He reports directly to CEO. We have manager, senior executives and executives working under him. They basically look, their key activities are payroll and claims processing, vendor payment processing, accounts payable, receivable and revenue tracking, financial accounting and reporting, and financial monitoring and control. There are four types of claims which they look after. One is domestic and international travel claims, mobile claims, fuel claims, and other payment voucher. When we go to the tool demo, we will be actually looking at the claims and how we should put our claims in the system. So we will cover the policy part in that demo. So now coming to marketing department. So the head of the marketing have executive research and associate marketing, associate executive marketing, and he directly reports to CEO. Now, marketing department is responsible for building the brand visibility. So they organize, they host events in which they engage the target segment. They do video shoots for customer testimonials. They post it in our social media. They increase the brand visibility through public relation, that is your newspaper, magazine. They look after all these public relations area, media coverages, etc. They also increase the brand visibility through digital media and social platforms like FB, Twitter, LinkedIn, YouTube. They handle all these handles. And they are also into lead generation through email marketing and telecalling events and social media. They also are in charge of collateral creation and printing. They are also into marketing in market intelligence and research about which sector, which geography we should cater to, etc. They are also part of internal marketing and communication. This is where they work with us, with HR and other department for internal marketing and communication. Now, coming to my department, that is HR. We have a head HR and admin. I report to him. Senior manager, that is me. And then we have HR manager Rupesh, who looks after HR operations. We have various HR executives and admin executives reporting to head HR. Recently, our head HR has recently changed. So he is actually on the way. Currently, we are directly reporting to CEO for interim period. To CEO also, as I mentioned, Anil sir is looking after recruitment department for the time being. So he is also a part of HR department now. So that's a interim arrangement. So basically, this will be the structure for HR department, overall HR department. We will be having a head HR and admin person, and we will be reporting to him. So now, coming to the key activities, we are concerned with all the talent acquisition, recruitment related activities, onboarding and training development, performance management, your development, talent management, total rewards, facility management, admin is looking after facility management, leave attendance, tracking your food, travel, stay, etc. So now let's move on to the tool demo, which you will be using in your stint at Hybar. So basically, this is the platform, the HRMS portal called OneHR. This is the platform you will be using in your stint at Hybar. So daily you will be logging in and logging out in this portal. So let me take you, give you an overview of this portal. Before that, there is another portal which you need to be aware of, that is HGS, Hinduja Global Solution Limited. They are our vendors for payslip and tax declaration. So basically, you will be receiving a mail from them with your credentials and your payslips, everything that has been automated. So they will be talking to you directly, sending you mails regarding your payslips and credentials for logging in the portal. So your tax declaration and payslips you will be able to access in this portal. I'll not be giving a demo tool, but I'll be taking you through OneHR. That's a tool which you will get a mail from HGS directly during your salary period. Whenever the salary gets credited, you will automatically get a mail from them regarding the credentials. Before I proceed to OneHR, let me just give you a brief about salary cycle. So we have a cycle from 25th of previous month to 24th of this month. That's our salary cycle. So and the salary gets credited on 6th of each month. So we complete the process by 24th, and we submit the data to HGS portal by 26th or 27th. And then they process the salary. They also process the FNF. So we have actually outsourced it to HGS. So on 6th, it gets credited to your bank account. Now let me move to the OneHR tool demo. So this is what your OneHR looks like. Before I log into the OneHR and talk about the tool we have, let me just tell you about something which you will receive. That is our welcome mailer. So you will be receiving a mail from OneHR stating that OneHR is here and welcome to Hybar with your employer ID in the mail body, and then your login credential, username, password, etc. In this mailer, you will be having multiple files, guides, user guides, and master activity list, master client list, multiple guidebooks to refer to. Let me tell you one thing. As soon as you receive the mail, please change your default password by logging into the system and check for your department and reporting hierarchy whether the personal details mentioned there is correctly mentioned or not. If not, please get back to us. I'll tell you how to get back to us also. There is a HR database form which will be included in the mailer. You have to click on this link and fill the form. So this will have a link like this. It's a Microsoft form. It will ask you for a few of the personal information. So you have to just, it's a dynamic form. You have to fill in these information and then click on next and then submit. It's a lengthy form. It will take around 15 minutes of your time. Please fill it up and submit. If there is no information available, you can put NA and proceed, but please fill all the mandatory fields. Also, in case there is no validity for your certificates, you can put a future date, that is 999. You can put in year as 9999 or 3000. The system will understand that's a future date. Okay. Now, this is the mail which you will receive. In this mail, you will also have contact details of POCs like IT and IT laptop, etc. Related things. You have to reach out to Brijesh, Sandeep. For joining formalities, you have to reach out to the recruiters. These are our recruiters. For HR operation and payroll, Rupesh Viral is the one. For claims, podium payment voucher, you can reach out to this person, Spock from accounts team, that is Shashank Seller. Attendance timesheet, project shift related queries, you can reach out to Priyadarshini, Meghna or Rajeshri. For any kind of escalation, you can reach out to me. So now let's move ahead and go to the OneHR platform. So this is how it looks for looks as looks for OneHR platform. I'll be now logging into my access. It's my access. I'm giving you a demo of how it looks. For you, it will be your email ID. The credential will be your email ID, the official email ID, and HRMS@2020. That's the default password for every OneHR module. Okay, so you have to submit, enter your password, and then you have to submit. Just a second, I'll just share it again. So now let's go one by one. I will cover all the modules which are very important for you to proceed with your daily routine. So let's start with employee first. So this is a platform which is basically a service request creation platform. We have multiple department: accounts, finance, admin, human resources, technology and innovation. So if you have any grievances, any question, any issue you want to raise with any of the department, there are specific Spock assigned to each activity. So let's say if I select HR and then select a category, like let's say induction. So you this query, whatever service request you put, that will reach out to the service request will go to me. I will answer your queries. Similarly, for other categories, there are multiple categories and you can select your category and put in your service request. Similarly, it will get assigned to the Spock. There is a SLA for this closure of the service request. We have 5 days for human resources related activities. We have 7 days for accounts and finance. So it varies from activity, department to department. So you can put in your service request. It will have an SLA. We can track that. And post SLA, it will get auto-escalated to the head of the department. So you will definitely receive a closure on your service request. Okay. So even you have also a functional to escalate this service request. If you are not getting a solution which satisfies you, you can escalate it to head of the department. Now all the service requests can be tracked under My Service Request. You can also track the date of creation, the date of closure, etc. Now these three will not be visible to you. You will only be able to see these two tabs. This is for me because I am a service request closure person. So the Spock will be able to see these kind of tabs so that I can go into the details of the service request which you might have raised and close it. Now moving to the another module. So basically, I would request everybody to raise your service request through employee first. You cannot raise a grievance which cannot be solved, as in it doesn't require any action to be created. It might be a suggestion, so we would not like you to raise it in the employee first. It should be sent as a mail. So any kind of suggestion for improvement or any kind of policy related changes, We will encourage you to send it through mail and not to raise it through employee first, because SLA will not, there is an SLA for every service request, and we cannot cater to your requirement on an immediate basis. So it will get escalated, and you will not get the closure off for your service request. So that is why we recommend that you send us your suggestions or any change in policy. If you are looking for, you have to raise it through mail. For any kind of other services, you can raise employee first. We would encourage you to use service employee first as much as possible. Now, we also have photos, videos, vision. I would leave that to you to explore for you to explore. And then we have the timesheet, leaves, attendance module. Now I will take you through attendance, leaves, and timesheet module one by one. We also have claims, policy, procedures, and then recruitment module and KMS module. Before I move to these modules, I will just show you. This is the my corner part where you have all the personal information present. So these are the personal information which you can check. When I click on personal information, it will show a photo of yours, and then your location, your project assignment, your details, personal details, all will be captured here. You can verify that, and you can change it. So your current address, your passport details, your bank details, your mediclaim nominees, your emergency contact, your blood group, etc. Everything will be visible here. You need to verify and get back to us whether if there is, in case there is any emergency discrepancies. You can also put in employee first service request for any change required in basic details. You can raise those service requests, and we will get back to you as soon as possible. Now, apart from my details, there are other things which you can look forward to. That is, change password. You can change your password. You can put in your nomination. You can view your payslips, Form 16. These will direct you to the HGS portal, actually. So payslips and Form 16 will direct you to the HGS portal. We also have employee transfer module, which is basically used by program managers. They actually put in the name of the employee. The access is only to program managers. They can create employee transfer request from one project to another project. They will just select the name of the employee in their reporting structure. The donor department will program manager will initiate the process. So they will just select the employee name and then the project to which it needs he or she needs to be transferred. And once they submit the request, it will take 2 days for the transfer to happen. So the employee transfer can be done by only program managers. They can create a transfer request by clicking on the employee name and then selecting the project to which the person needs to be transferred to. This can be done by donor department program manager, and then it will get initiated after 2 days. So in the meanwhile, in these 2 days, the employee will get a mail asking to clear all the pending requests and leave requests, etc. So they will get a notification that these are the things which are pending for closure. So you have to clear all those things, and then only the transfer will get effective. Otherwise, after 2 days, if the pending claims and leave request does not get closed, it will go into a cancelled mode. That means you have to raise the claims and leave again in the system. Now, this is how the program manager creates a transfer request. Now, depending on your role, it will be visible to you. Now coming to policy and procedures. So you will be able to see all the policies, user manuals, forms here. So if you click on policies, HBT, then HR policies, you will be able to see a series of policies here. So this is how you can check all the policy documents. You can click on any of them. It will open the policy document for you. You can go through the policies. I would recommend every new joinee to go through all the HR HBT policies. It will be very helpful for you. There are user manuals for you so that you can access, you have a easy access to the user manual, attendance and timesheet, employee first and leave claims. All these user manuals are visible to you. You can always check the user manual for the procedures. And now I'll move to the next module called claims. We also have a KMS platform which will redirect you to a different SharePoint page where this is the knowledge management platform. We have different communities. I would request you to go through these and utilize it to the full potential. This is where you will share your project documents, you will join communities, you will have discussions. So please utilize the KMS platform. Now moving to the claims section. So as I mentioned, there are four kind of claims which we look into: mobile, fuel, travel and other claims. So mobile and fuel, depending on your band, it will be accessible. Basically 7 and above band, we allow for mobile and fuel claims. There might be exceptional cases where we allow mobile claims, so it will be basis your band. Now travel claims, you can submit your travel expenses. So you are a new joinee, you might be relocating, or maybe you have traveled during your business requirement. You have traveled to international place or domestic. You can put in your travel request, your accommodation details. You can put in all these details and submit the claim. The approval will be, the hierarchy will be in a particular way. The first project manager will approve, then program manager, and then delivery head. Only for claim there are three approval levels. For rest all it is two. Sometimes for other we have single approval also. If it is a support function and there is no other hierarchy such as such in my case, it is single authority for now. Now see, the other claims is basically to claim payment vouchers like let's say conveyance or per diem or internet charges or any kind of lunch and tea expenses while you were traveling, or let's say any kind of repair, IT asset repair things, or any kind of stationery and printing, etc. So these can be claimed here as a part of payment voucher. You can claim it and submit the bills, upload your bill and save and go ahead, click on submit. So this is how you can put in your vouchers. You can also view it under my payment vouchers. So that's about the claims. Now I will move to attendance, timesheet and leave module. So these are three important modules for which you will be logging into OneHR daily. OneHR is accessible in mobile devices. You can just paste your URL, this URL into your mobile browser or any kind of tablet if you are using, or any other personal device. You can put in this URL in your browser and you can access OneHR. So putting in, punching in and punching out, putting leaves, putting claims, putting in your timesheet for you, it's very easy to do because you can access it through mobile devices from any place with any browser. So that's about OneHR. I'm going to now describe in details about attendance, leaves and timesheet module. Please pay attention. This is very important for your day-to-day activity. I'll be talking about the rules, system rules, which are already present. And I hope everybody has received a mailer from me. OneHR is here for you. Welcome to HiBar. This is the subject line of that mailer. Please, if you have not received this mail, please put your name in the chat box. After this call, I'll get back to you and I'll check why the mail has not been sent to you. Okay. So in this mail, we have actually attached the attendance and 1 second. Rajeshri, can you please start the recording? I forgot to start the recording.
Yes, I have started it. I started it
Okay,
already.
great. Thank you. Thank you. So coming back to the mail. In this mail, you will find guidebooks, user guidebooks for many of the OneHR features. In that, attendance and timesheet is one of the major one. So you'll get to know all the rules, system rules, and all the policy related things in this particular user guidebook itself. There are few master files also, which is required as and when we discuss, I'll talk about it. In this mail itself, the username is and default password has been shared with you. So this is a very important mail. Please let me know if you haven't received it. Okay. Now, coming back to the attendance and timesheet module. So there are three boxes here you can see in OneHR. Probably, I hope everybody is aware of OneHR. It is an HRMS platform for our company. So we have attendance, timesheet, and leave modules inbuilt in it. We have internally developed. Earlier, we used to use a software called Jibyl for our attendance tracking, but we found a lot of issues with that. So we moved to an in-house tool. Okay. Now let me start with the attendance module first. So attendance module is nothing but check-in and check-out platform. So basically, you have biometric in offices installed. So we just punch in when we go, we start the duty and punch out when we come out of office, right? So that's what this module does. You just have to, you will see three tabs here. You have to go to record attendance. And once you click on record attendance, you will be able to see a page like this. And it will be quite different from what you are seeing currently because I have already checked in for the day. You are seeing the checkout button. But basically, when you start your duty of your day, you have to click on the check-in button. There will be a check-in button in here. After the shift in time range, there will be button here, check-in button. Once you click on it, then only checkout buttons get enabled. Okay, so let me start with the first thing which you see here. That is shift hours. Your full day shift hours will be visible here. Half day shift hours will be visible here. So it can be different for different people because there are different projects which have different work schedule. Okay. So they have different shifts. It might be 8 hours for few people. So it will be visible here. You can check your shift full day and half day. And likewise, you can perform your duty. So for example, for today's date, I can see a shift in time range here. And I clicked on check-in button. So the system has taken the server timing. Whenever I click on that check-in button, it will take the server timing. And it will register here. So let's say today I checked in at 9:26. It has taken that particular time. Then when I complete my work and log out of for the day, so I will click on checkout button and it will just log out of the system. It will take the server timing. Now, coming to shift in time range, it has a minimum and a maximum. This is a flexible time provided to everybody so that they can log in between a particular time period. So the maximum of the range is very important. Let's take an example of this schedule. This is a regular shift timing. Not a project client timing. It can be different for different projects. Let's take the example of this regular shift. So for me, it is 10 a.m. By 10 a.m., I have to log in. I can log in between 8:30 to 10 a.m. So basically, it is showing that if I log in by 8:30, I can log out by 5:30. My 9 hours gets completed by 5:30. If I log in by 10 o'clock, my 9 hours gets completed by 7 o'clock, but by 10 a.m. I have to be logged in. If I don't log in by 10 a.m. Just a second, I have to take this call. Sorry for a pause. I'll just take this call. This is an important one. Yeah, sorry for the pause. I'll continue now. So basically, shift in time range is 8:30 to 10 for me. So by 10, I have to be logged in into the system. If I don't log in by 10 o'clock, it will be counted as late coming, and I might face deduction for that. Another point is if I log in before 8:30. The system will start calculating at 8:30 only. That is the check-in minimum range. The system will start calculating the 9 hours from 8:30 only. That means if at all I'm logging in before 8:30, let's say I have a work to finish, so I want to log in early today, but my 9 hours get completed by 5:30 only, even if I log in before 8:30. Okay? Now coming to another scenario where there is a second half, I have taken leave for the first half and I am logged in second half. Okay? So now my second half starts at 2 o'clock. For 9 hour shift, it is 2 o'clock. For 8 hour shift, it is different. So it differs from project to project. For a regular shift, 9 hour shift, basically 2 o'clock is the in time for second half. So if I log in before in time, it will start calculating at 2 o'clock only. That means by 7 p.m. it will complete 5 hours. That is your half day shift. Okay? So if you are logging in at 2 o'clock, you have to be logged in till 7 p.m. to be counted as properly worked for second half. Okay? If you check out before that, there will be a deduction. I'll come to deduction part later. That's the second phase of our discussion. I'm just talking about the overall idea of shift in and shift out time range. Huh? Now, these details will also get captured here. In the below table, you can see my data being captured. So yesterday when I checked in at 9:15, it showed 9:15, and then I checked out. I clicked on the checkout button at 8:42. It just showed this exact timing, the server timing. It picked up and total hours. It just displayed. Here you can see a status button. यहाँ पे present दिखा रहा है. That means the first half is present. Second half is also present. There might be also different combinations जिसमें absent हो, present absent हो, absent present हो. You can see here ना. Just take note of this date. I'll come to the discussion later on. 6th July का date आप याद रखो. मेरा यहाँ पे absent and present था. That means I have logged in second half. Okay, I'll come to that discussion later on. Now, this display is also visible here. For example, if in case you have taken a leave, yahan pe green color mein update ho jayega, telling that it is your approved leave. If it is in yellow color, that means it is still pending for approval from your manager. Now, let me tell you something. Your holiday calendar has already been configured. Your shift timing has been configured already in the system as per the manager's input. If there is any change required, we follow a process. We ask the manager to give us the input and we change it from our backend. Okay. Now you can see a red color outline here, that is weekly off. For different project it is different. Generally everybody follow a regular Saturday Sunday off. There might be projects where it is 6 days working and Sunday is weekly off, or it is Friday Saturday weekly off and Sunday is working. So there are different scenarios. Okay. Now I think I've covered the full part here, the display part here. Only one point to be noted is the status does not change. Even if your leave, which has been deducted and it gets regularized later on, it doesn't change. Okay. We will come to the regularization, deduction and the deduction of leave later in the second phase. So I'll pause for a moment here. Any question regarding the display and anything you want to understand here? I'll pause for a moment and check whether if you have any question. You can unmute yourself and you can ask question. Okay, so I'm taking this as in yes, I'm going forward. Now let's discuss the deduction rules. As I mentioned, I have already shared this mail. There is a user guide. I would recommend everybody to at least go through the page number 4 of this guide, because it gives out a scenario the scenarios for which there are deduction. Okay. Anyway, I'll take you through the basic things which needs to be there in your mind when you check in and check out. But it will be recommended if you can go through these scenarios. This is in page number 4 of the guidebook. Okay. Now let's come back to the attendance module. Here let me start with the basic scenario. So let's say I logged in at 8:30 and I complete my 9 hours at 5:30 and I just click on checkout button, there will be no deduction because I completed my 9 hours. Let's say I started my work at 8:30 but I checked out at 4 o'clock. I did not complete my 9 hours time, so I will face a deduction of 0.5. The deduction happens in a particular fashion. The system will first look whether there is a sufficient balance, PL balance, privilege leave balance. It will first deduct PL. In case there is insufficient PL, it will then look for SL, that is sick leave. Then it will, in case there is insufficient sick leave, it will, after that, it will recommend LOP for you. Okay. This is the scenario when there is a this is a scenario for on-roll employees. In case of retainers and interns, it will directly look into the PL balance. If PL balance is not sufficient, it will directly advise LOP for you. Okay. Now let's come back to the scenarios we were discussing. So if it is less than 9 hours, 0.5 gets deducted. If it is a half day, you have taken a half day. Let's say maine first half maine work kiya and second half I'm going on leave. So if I logged in at 8:30 and if I log out before 2 o'clock, it will deduct 0.5 again for me. That means aapne already 0.5 liya hua hai half day. And if you don't follow the 5 hours timing, it will deduct 1 day for you. Okay? So you have to be very careful when you are taking a half day. Similarly, when you are taking a second half day leave, you have to be careful that you are completing your 5 hours. Please try to log out by after 7 o'clock. That is, yahan pe mera shift out time maximum is 7 o'clock. If I log out after 7 o'clock, it will correctly register. So by 2 o'clock I log in, after 7 o'clock I log out, it will not deduct anything for you. But in case you log out, let's say I log in, I thought that I will work a little bit earlier. 12 o'clock I'll log in, second half mein, and I would like to log out again earlier. So let's say main 7 o'clock ke jagah pe, I log out at 5 o'clock. Then the system will not allow you and it will deduct 0.5 because aapne timing hi follow nahi kiya. That is 2 o'clock you should log in. And 7 o'clock, you should log. So after 7 o'clock, you should log out. The point is, Even if you are logging before 2 o'clock, it will start calculating at 2 o'clock only. So आपका 5 hours 2 o'clock से लेके start होगा for second half. So that thing has to be kept in mind when you are checking out. ठीक है? Now a logout can happen after 7 o'clock. It is not mandatory to follow the range which has been given. Only thing you need to keep in mind whether it is completing the 9 hours or not, or 5 hours in case of half day. ठीक है? So I have covered the scenario for deductions, leave deduction. Now I'll move to how to tackle when there is a deduction for you. So at every day midnight, a scheduler runs. It will check for your rules, whatever rules just I mentioned, ki usne 9 hours cover kiya ya 5 hours cover kiya, is there a pre-planned leave on that day. Wo sab rules check karke system will run a scheduler, and then it will trigger a mail to you telling that acha such and such dear such and such person, aapka 0.5 deduction hua hai because you were absent on this particular half day, or you were absent for the full day, 0.5 deduct hua hai, please regularize in case it is a mispunch. Usme ek link diya hoga mail pe, you have to click on that mail link and come back to this portal, or you can go to the attendance menu, log into 1HR, go to attendance menu and go to the other tab called regularize attendance. I'll come to that part now. I'll pause here for a moment. Let me know if you have question regarding the attendance page and deductions which are happening. You people have any question, or should I proceed to the next step? Next step is about how to handle if there is any deduction. Okay. So there is no question. I'm proceeding forward. Now let me just click on the attendance menu. I'm going back to the attendance menu. In that I will click on the regularize attendance tab. Okay. This is the tab I was talking about. I have a scenario here. I was not present on that day. This was a leave for me. So now see, this is how it will look for you. In case, let's say you were absent on 4th August. Assume that this is not 21st July, it is 4th August. Huh? So it has registered. I forgot to punch in and punch out on a proper timing, in my proper timing. So now it has deducted a PL for me. Now what to do? Now you have to come back to regularize attendance. And then you have to click on the drop down here. There will be two values which will be appearing for you. One is sick leave, one is mispunch. Mispunch, there are two cases. Mispunch ka, let me first explain the mispunch part. Mispunch basically represents if you have logged in late. Let's say aapne 10 baje ke baad login kiya, late coming ho gaya, and there is a 0.5 deduction for you. Let's say you have forgot to punch in because you were busy with a meeting. You logged in at correct timing, but you forgot to punch in the system. Uske wajah se aapka 0.5 deduct ho gaya. Ya fir you forgot, totally you forgot to punch for the day altogether. So ye sab cases ho sakta hai. Okay, it is possible that these are genuine cases. You might be busy with your work and you forgot it. So the system will allow you to regularize those mispunches for, it will give you a window of 24 hours the next day. That is, if maine 4 tarikh ko apna mispunch kiya, mispunch hua mera, I forgot to punch, it will start showing in the system, regularize attendance ki tab mein it will show 5th August ko, that is today. It will show that 4th August ko aapne ek PL deduct hua hai aapka, please regularize. So yahan pe instead of sick leave, there will be a mispunch also in the drop down. I can select, but that option will be valid till 24 hours. That is 5th August ke EOD tak aapko wo karne ko milega. The window is 24 hours to regularize a mispunch. Also, there is another rule to mispunch. You are allowed to regularize 3 mispunches per month. तो आप ये जो फॉरगॉट और लेट कमिंग दीज आर ओनली दिस कैन हैपन ओनली 3 times अ मंथ. ओके, तो आप जब रेगुलराइज करते हो यू हैव टू सिलेक्ट दैट मिस पंच वैल्यू हियर, पुट इन योर रिमार्क्स, लेट्स से कुछ भी वट एवर यू वॉन्ट टू पुट इन की फॉरगॉट टू पंच एटसेट्रा, एंड देन क्लिक ऑन सबमिट बटन. ठीक है, तो वंस यू क्लिक ऑन सबमिट इट विल गो टू योर रिपोर्टिंग मैनेजर एंड देन ही विल अप्रूव. एंड आफ्टर अप्रूविंग जो डिडक्शन हुआ है आपका यहाँ पे पीएल, इट विल रिवर्स बैक, मतलब आपका जो बैलेंस है वो रिस्टोर हो जाएगा. जो बैलेंस पीएल, बैलेंस एसएल जो भी है डिडक्शन, वो रिस्टोर हो जाएगा. बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली द स्टेटस विल नॉट चेंज, इट विल रिमेन एज इज, बिकॉज ये थोड़ा टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लम है. वी कैन नॉट चेंज द स्टेटस, इट 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 हैज अ लॉग्स अटैच टू इट. So the display here will not change, but in the leaves module, you will be able to see the reversal happening. Okay, we will come to that. Now we will go to that module after this attendance module. So we will discuss in detail. Now coming back to after mispunch, let me talk about SL. Now we can also regularize SL. What do you mean by regularization of SL? That means, जब deduction होता है, it will by default first take PL, उसके बाद SL. देन एलओपी. इनकेस पीएल डिडक्ट कर देता है दैट डे, लेट जैसे कि ये केस में 21 जुलाई को मेरा सिक लीव था एंड इट डिडक्टेड पीएल फॉर मी, आई कैन रेगुलराइज इट टू एसएल. दैट मीन्स आई कैन चेंज दिस पीएल टू एसएल बाय क्लिकिंग हियर एसएल एंड पुटिंग इन माय रिमार्क्स एंड सबमिटिंग. दिस कैन बी डन विद इन 15 days ऑफ द डेट ऑफ लीव, दैट इज 21st से लेके 15 days का विंडो मेरे पास होता है to regularize the SL. So now let me come to my recommendation here, my tip here. So whenever you are taking any leave, let's say you are not feeling well, you are sick for a reason, or you have some other activity to do, please do not punch out for that day. Regularize kar sakte, have to take any, you don't have to put any leave. Okay, now ye possible hai when that is a backdated leave. If it is a future dated leave, or if you want to avail a time off, this is not possible. So only in case of backdated leaves aap aise kar sakte ho. That means any kind of future dated leave, if you have any planned leave, if you have, you cannot follow this process. You cannot मतलब punch out punch in नहीं करके फिर बाद में कर सकते हैं, ऐसा नहीं हो सकता, because obviously वो day basis पे चलता है. ठीक है, तो future dated leaves के लिए we will go to leave module now and look how we will look at the process how to put in future dated leaves. ठीक है, now this is only for backdated leave. Now let me cover something else. I'll go back to attendance module. जो भी regularization आज तक मैंने किया है, the history will be visible to you in this inbox regularization. यहाँ पे आपको status दिख जाएगा, status में आपको पता चल जाएगा whether the manager has approved or it is pending for approval. Now let's take a example. 7-7 को मैंने एक request डाला था. Let's take this example 6-7 July. I just mentioned that, right? It was showing me absent and present. Remember this. Now we will go to leave module. उसमें देखेंगे whether the PL which was deducted 0.5 is has it been regularized or not. ठीक है, यहाँ पे मिस पंच है, फॉरगॉट पंच मैंने रिमार्क में डाला हुआ है, वो अप्रूव होके है. Although it is approved, the status display has not changed. As I mentioned, it is impossible, difficult for us to change the status. So status will remain as is in the attendance module, but leave will be reversed. Now I'll pause for a moment and take your questions before I proceed to the leave module. Any question if you have regarding the attendance module, regularization of attendance, miss punches, sick leave, you can ask me now. After that, we'll move to leave module.
Ma'am, only I was having query about the status part, which is you have, explained that the okay. Status will not be changed. So
yes, no question. Yeah. Okay. So that anyway, I'm going to show you now. तो वो आपको क्लियर हो जाएगा. स्टेटस विल नॉट शो, इट इज जस्ट अ डिस्प्ले. हाँ, इट डजंट चेंजेस बिकॉज उसके साथ लॉग्स अटैच्ड है. एनी अदर क्वेश्चन, एनी अदर क्वेरी, विल गो टू लीव मॉड्यूल नाउ. प्लीज मेक नोट ऑफ दिस डेट, 6 जुलाई. हाँ, लेट्स गो बैक. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू लीव मॉड्यूल. दिस इज द लीव्स मॉड्यूल. टाइमशीट, लीव एंड अटेंडेंस आर ऑल इंटरलिंक्ड. बिफोर आई स्टार्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट लीव मॉड्यूल एंड शो यू वेदर द रेगुलराइजेशन हैज हैपेंड, लेट मी गिव यू अ ब्रीफ अबाउट लीव्स ऑल्सो फ्रॉम पॉलिसी स्टैंड पॉइंट बिकॉज देर आर फ्यू न्यू ज्वाइनीज इन द कॉल. प्रिविलेज लीव फॉर, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ऑन रोल एम्प्लॉयज फॉर द टाइम बींग. सो फॉर ऑन रोल एम्प्लॉयज, प्रिविलेज लीव गेट्स अक्रूड पर मंथ. As in, on completion of a month, you will get 2.5 privilege leave. In case of retainer and intern, it is different. I will come to that after this. Sick leave, for sick leave, it is a lump sum amount which gets credited to you on the day of joining. Basically, we follow a leave cycle of, the leave cycle is being followed from January to December. This is the calendar year what we follow. There is a carry forward on this on December 31st, your privilege leave will get carry forward. The cap limit is 90 days. 90 days of privilege leave gets carry forward. The cap limit for sick leave is 60 days. So your sick leave will get carry forward up to 60 days of leave. Okay? Now, beyond the 90 days of privilege leave, if there is any other any few days of leave are there, PL is there, it gets encashed in January, in the January payroll. ठीक है? So 90 days carry forward होता है, उसके beyond over and above 90 days encashment होता है. Sick leave 60 days carry forward होता है, no encashment. ठीक है? Now coming back to the earning, so 10 sick leaves per year होता है. So when you join mid-year, it will be a prorated number. आपको screen पे prorated number दिख रहा होगा. पूरा 10 years नहीं दिख रहा होगा, 10 days नहीं दिख रहा होगा, sorry. Now coming to time off. Time off is basically, other companies call it casual leaves or emergency leaves. So basically time off is a emergency kind of leave. So for example, if you want to take a emergency leave today, you can put in time off. Time off has to be applied in advance only. You cannot put in backdated time off. Okay. Privilege leave and sick leave can be backdated. जैसे मैंने आपको बोला, attendance में punch out मत कीजिए, वो automatically register कर देता है system. PL deduct हो जाता है, या फिर if you want SL, वो regularize हो जाएगा. But if you want to take future dated PL and SL, you can come here and apply. Now let me talk more about time off here. Time off does not get encashed, does not get carry forward. So you have to spend all the time off जितना आता है, total 6 आता है per year. तो आपको prorated दिख रहा होगा, जितना भी दिख रहा होगा, you have to use that off. ठीक है? जितना time off आपको मिला है by December, please use it. Now there are few rules to time off. So time off can be at max can be taken one day. It cannot be clubbed with PL and SL. It cannot be subsequently. You cannot put time offs. मतलब आज भी time off डाला, कल भी time off डाला, it doesn't allow that. वो emergency के cases में लेने के लिए है. So at max आप one day का डाल सकते हो at one go. या फिर 0.5 का डाल सकते हो, या फिर टुडे यू कैन पुट फॉर 0.5, टुमारो यू कैन पुट फॉर 0.5. इट विल अलाउ एट वन गो, इट विल अलाउ वन डे का टोटल, अप टू वन डे का टाइम ऑफ. ठीक है? सो दिस इज व्हाट इज टाइम ऑफ. पीएल एंड एसएलआई ऑलरेडी मेंशन. नाउ कमिंग टू द रिटेनर्स एंड इंटर्न्स, दे डू नॉट हैव सिक लीव, सो दे हैव पीएल. उनका उनका इंटर्न्स के लिए सिर्फ पीएल होता है. टाइम ऑफ इज देयर फॉर रिटेनर आल्सो, बट पीएल उनका एक्रू होता है 1 per month, अनलाइक ऑन रोल पीपल. ठीक है? नाउ अप्लाई, आई विल गो टू अप्लाई लीव नाउ. दिस इज योर बैलेंस कार्ड, आई मीन लीव कार्ड फॉर 2021. यू विल बी एबल टू सी योर बैलेंसेस हियर. यहाँ पे ओपनिंग आपको दिख जाएगा. I can apply the future dated, as I mentioned, future dated PL and sick leave here. But for sick leave, यू हैव टू अप्लाई बाय प्रोवाइडिंग अ डॉक्यूमेंट. यहाँ पे आपको थोड़ा सा डॉक्यूमेंट देना पड़ेगा बिकॉज इट्स अ मेडिकल केस. तो आपको जब फ्यूचर डेट ऑफ सिक लीव आप ले रहे हो, फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम गोइंग फॉर एन ऑपरेशन नेक्स्ट मंथ, आई हैव टू अप्लाई फॉर 14 डेज, आई कैन पुट इन माई डॉक्यूमेंट्स एंड आई कैन गो. फ्यूचर डेटेड पीएल के लिए, प्लान लीव के लिए यू डोंट हैव टू पुट एनी डॉक्यूमेंट, इट डजन हैव टू बी देयर. टाइम ऑफ यू कैन पुट, जैसे मैंने बोला 1 डे का, इट डजन हैव टू यू डोंट हैव टू अपलोड एनी डॉक्यूमेंट फॉर दैट. There is no supporting required. Now it is easier to do here. It's very basic. आपको PL या time of ऐसे select करना है, and then you can put your date and days of leave days, and then remarks. There are validation to it. आप अगर time of ज़्यादा डालना try करोगे तो वो नहीं allow करेगा आपको. Full day या फिर half day ही कर सकते हो आप. पर privilege leave you can put for how many days is possible for you. जितना भी balance में है आपका. There is an approver name appearing here. Basically, project locations ke employees ke liye, there might be cases where there will be two approvers appearing here. One is project manager, one is program manager. For support function, it is not necessarily like that. It will be directly the RM, reporting manager. Theek hai? Now, similarly, here you can see the leaves applied for you. Huh? In the yellow color, green color, you can see the leaves applied for you. So it will also be visible here. I will pause here for a moment and take your questions regarding leave before I proceed to the regularization part, where we will see how the leaves appear. Should I proceed then? Okay. Rajeshi, I suppose Saurav has not has pinged me asking, but I can see Saurav here. Saurav,
no, he has joined. He has joined after that.
Cool, cool.
He did manage cool. Join.
Cool.
Yeah, okay. Lagta hai join. Yeah.
Cool. Okay. So now coming back to my leaves corner. So remember I told you about 6th July. Now let's see whether it is there. So here you can see all my leaves present here. The details of the leaves are also present here. So here if you can see यहाँ पे 6 July का entry ही नहीं है. So 7 July को मैंने apply किया है TO, but 6 July का entry नहीं है. That means my leave got reversed and balance restore हो गया. जो भी balances था मेरा PL and SL का regularize होने के बाद हो गया. Although the display did not change there. So there are people who have asked this question. That's why I'm repeating once again this thing to clear your confusion. Even after regularization, wo display waisa ka waisa rahega. Regularization ho jayega system. You can come here and check it. Now coming to the leaves which has been generated due to system. Let me show you how it looks. यहाँ पे आपको सिस्टम जनरेटेड का एक मैसेज आ जाएगा. यू कैन नॉट मॉडिफाई द लीव्स हियर. यू कैन ओनली रेगुलराइज द दीज काइंड ऑफ लीव्स इन द अटेंडेंस मॉड्यूल एंड दैट टू मिस पंचेस के लिए 24 आवर्स, सिक लीव के लिए 15 डेज का विंडो है. ओके, नाउ वी हैव कवर्ड आवर लीव पार्ट. आई विल जस्ट शो यू क्विकली द लीव रिपोर्ट. आपका लीव रिपोर्ट भी जनरेट होता है यहाँ पे. यू कैन शो, यू कैन सी द रीजंस एंड ऑल यू हैव पुट. कैंसिल दिखा रहा है, दैट इज इट इज ऑलरेडी रेगुलराइज. हाँ, मैंने जहां पे रेगुलराइज कर दिया है वो सब कैंसिल स्टेटस में आएगा. बाकी सब अप्रूव्ड है, दैट मीन्स इट इज ऑलरेडी डन. पेंडिंग स्टेटस भी कुछ आते हैं. पेंडिंग स्टेटस इफ योर मैनेजर हैज नॉट येट अप्रूव्ड योर लीव. ठीक है, नाउ फॉर टीम मैनेजर्स, इफ एनीबडी इज प्रेजेंट हियर टीम मैनेजर, टीम कैलेंडर भी आता है. आई कैन नॉट शो दिस बिकॉज आई डोंट हैव एक्सेस. There is nobody reporting to me. तो आपके केस में, टीम मैनेजर के केस में, यू विल बी एबल टू सी योर टीम्स टीम का लीव्स, लीव कार्ड. ठीक है, नाउ कमिंग बैक टू द टाइम शीट. सो नाउ आई विल मूव टू द टाइम शीट मॉड्यूल. आई होप देर इज नो क्वेश्चन. आई एम मूविंग फॉरवर्ड. ओके, नाउ अटेंडेंस मॉड्यूल इज प्योरली चेक इन चेक आउट. टाइम शीट इज समथिंग डिफरेंट. इट इज जस्ट टू ट्रैक योर प्रोडक्टिविटी. आप आपने क्या काम किया है उस दिन, हाउ मच टाइम यू हैव स्पेंट. बेसिकली ये इसलिए लाया गया बिकॉज देर आर इन प्रोजेक्ट प्रोजेक्ट टीम्स यू विल देर आर बिलेबल रिसोर्सेस. ओके, पीपल पीपल गेट बिल्ड ऑन द वर्क आइटम और द टाइम्स दे हैव स्पेंट ऑन अ पर्टिकुलर वर्क आइटम फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर प्रोजेक्ट. पीपल आर वर्किंग ऑन मल्टीपल प्रोजेक्ट्स ऑल्सो, तो उनका जितना टाइम उस पर जाता है दे बिल बिल दैट टू क्लाइंट. एट द एंड ऑफ द एवरी मंथ डिप्लॉयमेंट रिपोर्ट इज टेकन आउट फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर टूल. तो आपके मैनेज प्रोग्राम मैनेजर एंड डिलीवरी हेड दैट इज कॉस्टअप, वो लोग डिप्लॉयमेंट रिपोर्ट रेडी करते हैं एंड सेंड इट टू क्लाइंट फॉर बिलिंग पर्पज. सो इट दिस इज वेरी एसेंशियल फ्रॉम दैट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. हाँ, इट इज वेरी इट इज मैंडेटरी टू फिल एवरी डे. दैट इज अटेंडेंस एंड टाइमशीट गोज हैंड इन हैंड, आपको भरना पड़ेगा एवरी डे. बट अटेंडेंस का क्या है, आपको उसी दिन ही चेक इन चेकआउट करना है, पर इसमें फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी है. देर इज अ फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी, आई विल कम टू दैट. अटेंडेंस का, बिफोर दैट आई विल टेल यू समथिंग. अटेंडेंस का साइकिल होता है फ्रॉम 25th ऑफ प्रीवियस मंथ टू 24th ऑफ दिस मंथ. आपको ऑन 21st, 22nd, 23rd यू विल गेट थ्री रिमाइंडर्स फ्रॉम सिस्टम, ऑटो जनरेटेड रिमाइंडर टू फिल योर टाइमशीट एंड रेगुलराइजेशन अप टू डेट करने के लिए. आपको एक रिमाइंडर भेजा जाएगा फ्रॉम सिस्टम बाय 24th ऑफ द मंथ, सो दैट बाय 25th आई कैन पुल आउट द रिपोर्ट. पेरोल टीम को आई कैन गिव द डेटा. ठीक है, आपका अटेंडेंस डेटा आई कैन गिव इट टू पेरोल टीम. ठीक है, सो वी फॉलो दिस स्ट्रिक्टली. 25th टू 24th ऑल रेगुलराइजेशन, ऑल द टाइमशीट डिटेल्स शुड बी फिल्ड इन. आपका अप टू डेट होना चाहिए. डजेंट मैटर इफ योर मैनेजर, यू हैव सेंट इट टू योर मैनेजर एंड ही हैज नॉट अप्रूव्ड योर टाइमशीट एटसेट्रा, वो हम लोग वी हैंडल इट फ्रॉम बैक एंड. पर आपके तरफ से इट शुड बी डन फ्रॉम योर एंड. ओके, नाउ नाउ कमिंग बैक टू टाइमशीट, आई विल टेल यू नाउ अबाउट टाइमशीट. व्हाट इज टाइमशीट? बेसिकली वी रिकॉर्ड ऑल द एक्टिविटीज डन फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर डे. व्हेन आई क्लिक ऑन रिकॉर्ड टाइमशीट, यू विल नॉट सी द टेबल ऑन द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द वीक. हाँ, इट विल बी अ ब्लैंक, जस्ट जस्ट अ ब्लैंक विथ फ्यू फील्ड्स, डेट, आवर्स, प्रोजेक्ट, टास्क. ये मैंने पिछले डेमो सेशंस में यूज कर दिया, दैट्स व्हाई द टेबल हैज कम अप. आपको पहले डेट, आवर्स, प्रोजेक्ट, टास्क ये दिखेगा. देन व्हेन यू फर्स्ट एंटर योर फर्स्ट टास्क फॉर द वीक, देन ओनली दिस टेबल क्रॉप्स अप. सो यू हैव टू एंटर अ टास्क बिफोर द टेबल क्रॉप्स अप. ओके, नाउ द साइकिल फॉर द विंडो प्रोवाइडेड फॉर टाइमशीट इज फ्रॉम मंडे टू संडे. एट मिडनाइट ऑफ संडे all the timesheet you have entered, the activities you have entered for a day get submitted to your manager automatically. So it goes out for their approval. My recommendation here is to fill all your timesheet on a daily basis. Although we have provided you a flexibility from Monday to Sunday, but please try to fill it on the daily basis so that you can remember what you have done. It is not a challenge for support function because they don't have to enter all the project and total jitna bhi work item dala hai. We just put in the majorly what work we have done. To hum log ek task select karte hain and then we put in the details about the task and submit it. But for project people, they have to follow strictly the projects and the task, the hours has to be maintained properly. So it's better to do it, make it a practice of doing it every day. So it will be easier for you. Now coming to the calendar which you see here, it might differ for you because as I mentioned, it differs because weekly off and working schedules are different for different project. For me it is Saturday, Sunday. So mera Sunday ko timesheet gets submitted. So I have to fill it by Friday. It will be easier for me. But people who have Sunday working day, उनको by Sunday evening तक जैसे भी हो भरना पड़ेगा, ठीक है? Because Sunday midnight everybody's timesheet gets submitted. Once it is submitted, if there is any deduction because of the time incomplete timesheet submission, वो मैनेजर को आप बोल के यू कैन सेंड इट बैक फॉर करेक्शन. आई विल कम टू दैट, हाउ यू कैन करेक्ट योर टाइम शीट एंड एटसेट्रा. आई विल कवर दैट पार्ट आफ्टर दिस. जैसे ही आपको करेक्शन के लिए टाइमशीट मिलता है, प्लीज करेक्ट इट एंड सेंड इट बैक टू योर मैनेजर. डू इट एज सून एज पॉसिबल, बिकॉज देर आर फ्यू केसेस वी हैव नोटिस दैट मैनेजर हैज गॉन फॉरवर्ड एंड थॉट दैट द पर्सन इज नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन सबमिटिंग करेक्ट टाइमशीट एंड दे हैव गॉन फॉरवर्ड एंड अप्रूव द लीव. दैट मीन्स द डिडक्शन ही हैज अप्रूव्ड एंड दे वर नॉट एबल टू चेंज इट बैक. So, as soon as you receive a mail from the system telling that your leave has been deducted because you did not fill your timesheet, please go ahead and check with your manager and tell them that please send it back for correction. Then they will send it back to you. You correct it and send it back to them. Wo reverse ho jayega. Jaise attendance mein leave reversal ho jata hai, waise same way mein yahan pe bhi leave jo deduct hota hai, wo reverse ho jata hai. Theek hai? Now, let me tell you how to do it. अभी डे लेट्स अज्यूम दैट मेरा 5 अगस्त का अभी जो सेशन चल रहा है, आई विल पुट इन अ डेट. फिर मैं ये HHMM फॉर्मेट में आई विल पुट इन माई टाइम एंड देन आई विल चूज अ प्रोजेक्ट. देयर द प्रोजेक्ट फॉर द ड्रॉप डाउन हैज बीन फिल्ड विथ ऑल द प्रोजेक्ट विच वी हैव रिसीव्ड. इन केस देयर इज अ प्रोजेक्ट मिसिंग, प्लीज रीच आउट टू योर मैनेजर. योर मैनेजर विल बी कोऑर्डिनेटिंग विथ अस फॉर दैट. नाउ आई विल जस्ट सिलेक्ट HO बिकॉज मैं सपोर्ट प्रोजेक्ट में हूँ. Now I am selecting HO. I can select any task. I will reiterate the fact that the mail which has been provided to you, it has master list, master activity list and master client list. Okay, you can refer to those if you are not able to find any activity. Let's say I will put some meeting. I'm just putting an internal meeting here. I can search that session on attendance. ठीक है. Now I can click on submit. जैसे ही मैं submit click करती हूँ, this particular 1 hour will be visible here. Summary में, ठीक है? Now you can see I can put in multiple activity for a particular day, multiple projects I can put. It will all be projected here. आपको display में यहाँ पे मिलेगा. Even if you पुट सेम डे पे सेम टास्क के लिए सेम एक्टिविटी के लिए दो दो अलग अलग टाइमिंग आप डालोगे, इट विल एड अप एंड शो इट हियर. इंटरनल मीटिंग में आपको दो चार तारीख का दो टू आवर्स दिख रहा है, राइट? सो दिस इज हाउ इट विल शो. नाउ आई विल टेल यू समथिंग हियर. यू कैन नॉट डिलीट वंस यू एंटर द टास्क, ठीक है? हाउ टू एडिट इन केस यू हैव इनकरेक्टली पुट इन अ टास्क. लेट्स से मैंने जो ये 5 तारीख का डाला, एनीवे आपको हर दिन का कुछ ना कुछ टास्क डालना ही है, ठीक है? तो अगर आपने 5 तारीख को मैंने जो ये अभी एंटर किया, इट इज एक्चुअली सपोज टू बी देयर फॉर 4th August एंड आई फॉरगॉट टू आई हैव एंटर्ड इट फॉर 5th August. दैट्स माय मिस्टेक. हाउ टू डू इट? नाउ लेट मी जस्ट क्लिक ऑन एडिट हियर. इन केस माय रिकमेंडेशन इज टू यूज इट फॉर अनदर एक्टिविटी. आप यहाँ पे डिफरेंट एक्टिविटी डाल सकते हो. देयर मस्ट बी मीटिंग्स, मनी मल्टीपल मीटिंग्स, यू कैन रिप्लेस इट विथ योर मीटिंग. यू कैन चेंज द आवर्स ऑल्सो. यू कैन एडिट इट एंड सेव इट. इन केस यू हैव ऑलरेडी एग्जॉस्टेड योर एक्टिविटी लिस्ट फॉर द डे, यू डोंट हैव एनी एक्टिविटी टू पुट, वॉट आई डू इज आई पुट इन लंच और आई पुट इन आइडल आवर्स. वो कर सकती हूँ मैं टू एडिट इट. आई कैन नॉट डिलीट इट, सो आई हैव टू एडिट इट समहाउ. अगर कुछ नहीं मिलता है तो 0001 मिनट डाल देती हूँ. इट डजेंट मैटर इफ आई पुट इन 01 मिनट, इट डजेंट मेक अ इमेंस डिफरेंस. आई कैन जस्ट क्लिक ऑन 01 मिनट डाल के उसको सेव करके रख देती हूँ, ठीक है? नाउ फुल आपका जो टोटल आवर्स पुट इन फॉर अ डे इज विजिबल हियर इन द टेबल. आपको यू हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट बैलेंस आवर्स आर जीरो ऑलवेज. इन केस ऑफ लीव इट कैन बी 9, वो ऑटोमेटिकली इट विल पिक अप 0 आवर्स. बट इन केस ऑफ रेगुलर डेज यू हैव टू मेक श्योर इट इज 0 आवर्स. अदरवाइज अगर सपोज कर लीजिए कि दिस टाइमशीट हैज बीन सबमिटेड ऑन 8th, आई डोंट मेक एनी चेंजेस हियर एंड इट गेट सबमिटेड ऑन 8th, देन आई विल बी फेसिंग 5 डेज का लीव डिडक्शन. बिकॉज मेरा 9 आवर्स का टोटल शिफ्ट था एंड आई डिड नॉट टेक एनी लीव, बट आई हैवंट सबमिटेड एनी टाइमशीट. मैंने 3 आवर्स का डाला है, टोटल 9 आवर्स है, तो इट इज नॉट मैचिंग. सो दैट्स हाउ द डिडक्शन हैपन्स. तो 1 डे का कट गया होगा मेरा लीव, मेरे को मेल आया होगा ऑन 8th और 9th मॉर्निंग टेलिंग दैट योर लीव हैज बीन डिडक्टेड बिकॉज ऑफ इनकम्प्लीट टाइम शीट. नाउ आई हैव टू आस्क माय मैनेजर, गो बैक टू हिम एंड आस्क माय मैनेजर, ही विल सेंड इट बैक टू मी एंड यू विल बी एबल टू सी इट अंडर माय टाइम शीट हेडर. सो दिस इज वेयर यू विल बी एबल टू सी ऑल योर प्रीवियस टाइम शीट सबमिटेड. यहाँ पे मेरे को अप्रूव स्टेटस दिखा रहा है बट आप इनके इन योर केस इन केस यू हैव आस्क योर मैनेजर टू सेंड इट फॉर करेक्शन इट विल शो एज करेक्शन स्टेटस. देन यू हैव टू क्लिक ऑन द व्यू आइटम एंड देन एंटर डू द करेक्शन. आपको पूरा 9 आवर्स पूरा कंप्लीट उसमें सबमिट करना पड़ेगा एंड देन क्लिक ऑन सबमिट बटन. ठीक है, इन केस यू आर ऑन बेंच, यू आर नॉट और यू आर ऑन अ ट्रेनिंग पीरियड, लेट्स ए टैलेंट पूल एम्प्लॉयज, यू आर डूइंग योर ट्रेनिंग राइट, तो आपका पूरा दिन उसी में चला जाता है. यू डोंट हैव मल्टीपल एक्टिविटीज टू पुट, यू कैन ऑलवेज पुट इन 9 आवर्स फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर एक्टिविटी. तो यहाँ पे ट्रेनिंग के लिए आप पूरा सीधा 9 आवर्स डाल सकते हो. सी ऑलरेडी देयर इज एक्टिविटी प्रेजेंट फॉर टैलेंट पूल एम्प्लॉय, यू कैन सिलेक्ट दैट, बट जो बेंच पे है दे कैन जस्ट पुट इट आइडल आवर्स यहाँ पे डाल के दे कैन पुट. They can put the anything, learning के लिए, training के लिए, anything they can put. They can select the project bench and they can submit 9 hours. जैसे ही time sheet submit हो जाता है, you can also see your time sheet report में. For manager, team manager, they get to see a deployment report at the end of the month, जिसमें they will be able to see how many hours has been put in by their team for a particular project. ठीक है, सो दैट्स इट अबाउट द टाइम शीट अटेंडेंस एंड लीव मॉड्यूल. आई थिंक आई हैव कवर्ड एवरीथिंग एंड आई हैवंट मिस्ड एनीथिंग आउट. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन वी विल डिस्कस दैट नाउ. ओके, सो कुणाल I'm just asking you upfront because you have pinged me regarding your question. So if you have understood what I what is the answer for your question, or otherwise we'll discuss on that fact on the question also. If you have any other query.
No, Nirlita. I've actually got a mail saying that your timesheet has been reversed, and I've clicked and edited the timesheet. I don't know the next stuff. राइट नाउ माई बैलेंस आई थिंक समथिंग हैज गॉन रॉन्ग ओवर देयर. 1 मिनट करके कुछ तो मैंने भर दिया है बाय मिस्टेक, सो कैन आई करेक्ट दैट नाउ?
हाँ, यू कैन करेक्ट दैट, यू कैन करेक्ट दैट. आपको करेक्शन के लिए मिला था, यू रिवर्स इट बैक, यू आर सेइंग राइट, यू यू ट्राई टू डू करेक्ट इट एंड सेव करके रखा है आपने. सबमिट कर दीजिएगा, सबमिट नहीं करने तक वो जाता नहीं है.
नहीं, सबमिट कर दिया है मैंने, बट आई थिंक आई हैव बैलेंस आर शिफ्ट मेरे को 8.59 मिनट्स बता रहा है कहीं से. सो आई आई थिंक
ओके, सो यू कैन अगेन आस्क फॉर करेक्शन, यू कैन अगेन आस्क फॉर करेक्शन. हां, यू कैन अगेन आस्क फॉर करेक्शन. वो सर से ही मंगवा के लेना पड़ेगा आपको. करेक्शन के लिए वही भेज सकते हैं, उनके पास ऑप्शन है. यू कैन आस्क योर मैनेजर टू रिटर्न इट बैक, तो हो जाएगा.
ओके ओके,
एनीबॉडी एल्स? ओके ओके कुमार. Anybody else has any question, or else we'll close the call. Okay, so before we close the call, just a few tips. जैसे मैंने आपको बोला कि previously आपको अगर backdated आपको कोई leave लेना है, please don't punch in and punch out. वो automatically leaves register कर लेता है. In case of time off only, you have to put it in advance. Cancellation of leave. I hope I'm clear. It pops up ki mera bad quality network hai. I hope I'm audible. In case of cancellation of leave, please make sure that if you are taking any leave and you are going to cancel that, let's say aapne leave liya but some unfortunately you don't want to take it today and baad mein lena chahte ho aap because kaam aa gaya hai. So you have to cancel it before the date, the leave date. You cannot cancel the backdated leaves. Huh? You cannot do it backdated. Matlab, leave date chala gaya and you cannot cancel it. My recommendation, aap agar leave pe nahi ja rahe ho, you want to cancel, please cancel it as much as matlab, पॉसिबल हो सकता है, जितना जल्दी पॉसिबल हो सकता है, ठीक है। ये एक दूसरा टिप है, टिप है। थर्ड टिप इज प्लीज मेंटेन योर टाइम शीट प्रॉपरली। 9 आवर्स पूरा कवर करके रखिएगा, थोड़ा जरूरत पड़े तो बफर आवर्स दे के यू पुट इन योर टाइम शीट एक्टिविटीज, एंड 9 आवर्स पूरा प्रॉपर टाइमिंग रखेंगे तो आपको यू विल नॉट फेस एनी रिडक्शन, ठीक है। एंड डू इट डेली बेसिस पे। या दीज आर फ्यू पॉइंटर्स। यू मस्ट हैव रिसीव दैट मेलर, प्लीज गो थ्रू दोज गाइड बुक। इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू गो थ्रू दोज गाइड बुक्स बिकॉज उसमें रूल्स एंड पॉलिसीज रिलेटेड मैटर मेंशन है। यू कैन गो थ्रू दैट। इन केस ऑफ एनी क्वेरी यू कैन रीच आउट टू प्रियदर्शनी। यू कैन ऑलवेज रेज अ सर्विस रिक्वेस्ट इन एम्प्लॉय फर्स्ट बिकॉज दैट हैज एन SLA एंड वी विल बी एबल टू ट्रैक योर क्वेरीज, ठीक है। सो प्लीज रेज योर वॉट एवर क्वेरीज एंड issues, you can raise it on employee first. We will get back to you as soon as possible. Okay, then if there is no question, we conclude the session now. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, everybody, for joining the call. Nilay has a question. Please go ahead, Nilay. Unmute yourself.
Yeah, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yes.
Ma'am, can you just send me a mailer? This was my first session today.
Yes, I know. I have already discussion I have done with Ketki. I know this. You have joined recently. I think yesterday.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. I will send it to you. You don't worry. You will get it today.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. And one more thing, I forgot to mention. For every new joinees, we have a grace period of 7 days, huh? The rules and regulation which I mentioned, it doesn't kick starts on the day of your joining. You have 7 days ka grace period. After that, it starts. Already you are aware of the system, so now you can punch in and punch out. It doesn't have to wait for 7 days. But in case you are facing any issue or laptop issue, that's why we have given a 7 days ka buffer. Okay, just for your information. Okay, cool. Thank you, everybody. We'll conclude the session now.